Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, Quran Weekly. I am Yusha Evans. Inshallah, I just want to share with you briefly, you know, what really attracted me to Islam, because we don't have the context of the time to be able to go through my entire story of a period of years that it took me to finally come to Islam, you know. But the first things I knew about Islam were very negative, first and foremost. Back in 96, when I really first heard about Islam, 95, you know, the only things were, there was very negative. And it was not a lot of information about Islam. No one was talking about Islam. Islam wasn't on the news every single day. It wasn't in the newspaper. It wasn't in magazines. You know, no one really talked about Islam. And the only thing I knew about Islam is what I had heard from pastors, you know, that they worshiped the moon god or read in a book. They lived in a box in the desert in Saudi Arabia, etc. That Muslims were going to be the Antichrist and, you know, so on and so forth. It wasn't really until I was invited by a Muslim who I had known, who was not the best Muslim, actually. He was a cannabis salesman, if you want to give that any type of entitlement. But he actually invited me to go to Jum'ah. It was going to Jum'ah and really kind of listening, you know, to the Imam speak about, especially, you know, the rhetoric we hear at the beginning of a khutbah, that verily all praise belongs to Allah. We praise Him alone. We ask for His help alone. We seek His aid and His aid alone. We take refuge in Allah from the evil that lies within our own souls and our sinful nature. Whomever God guides cannot be misguided, etc. That caught my attention and attraction initially, but it wasn't the words that anyone were going to tell me, really they were going to convince me about Islam. It was not until the Imam gave me a Quran and I went home and I opened the Quran and started reading it, that the real attraction took place. And that is something that has always stuck with me, was the beauty of the book that so many of us as Muslims take for granted. You know, just the very opening of the book where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after Fatiha says, you know, this is the book that has no doubt in it, and it is a guidance for those who fear their creator. I mean, that's, you know, one of the boldest challenges that I have ever seen in any religious text at any place, much less at the very beginning. The beginning of the book is proclaiming its virtue. It's claiming that in the beginning, after this point, you will not find any doubt. You won't find any contradictions, any discrepancies. You won't find any mistakes, nothing. This book is perfect and it will guide you if you fear God. I mean, that was really, to me, a tantamount testament to the veracity of the book. And it, after that point, I really wanted to disprove the book. I really wanted to disprove that verse, because I couldn't wrap my head around the idea that Muslims, who I thought were the worst people on earth, could have the right religion. That was just something my brain was not ready to, you know, to comprehend. But you know, the more I read the book in an attempt to discredit it, the more it proved its veracity. The more it proved what it was. And this will always be the greatest miracle. The greatest miracle of Islam is the Quran. And we know that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is in the collection of Imam Muslim, narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said every prophet was sent with miracles to, you know, to prove their prophethood or their messengership. And he said, the miracle that I was sent with was the Quran. The Quran is my miracle. And that is a living testament to the fact of who the Prophet ﷺ was. The fact that we can pick up his miracle right now. We can look through it, we can read it, we can understand it. And this is not only his miracle alone, this is the miracle given to him by Allah. This is the speech of the Creator. This is the speech of the Creator. It is referred to as Kalamullah. This is the words of our Creator. So the Quran really was the thing that attracted me to Islam, because it is tangible. It is something that is unique, that no other religion can produce. No other religion, and this is a challenge I have made to every single world religion. Bring your tangible proof and let's put it to the test. Is it what it claims to be? And when that is done, we will find that the only thing that can stand on its own merit is the book from the Creator of the Quran. It stands on its own merit. Its challenges are repute through 1400 plus years. that the Creator challenges you in the book to find a contradiction. It's almost a bold commandment. I dare you, please, do your research. Try to find a contradiction. Try to bring something like it. And when you can't, then you know you need to admit and humbly submit yourself to the fact that this is what it is, and it is from the Creator of all that exists. So, you know, this is one advice that I have always had for people who were interested in Islam, that just take the Quran and take some time to look through it. I know it can be a bit intimidating, you know, this entire book, you know, but at least, you know, just take some diligence, even if it takes you years to read through the Quran. Take the diligence to read the book and from the Creator, because there is something very special about it. Realistically, there is something so special about it, and I've known that since the first time I heard it recited. Even though I didn't know what the Quran meant at that time, I had no understanding of the Arabic language, but when you hear the Quran recited, you can tell there's something different about this. And it was very intriguing to me to, wow, this is how they read their book. You know, I wonder, do they read the whole book like this? And it's just very, very beautiful. It's a very beautiful thing. And even in the English language, which is not the Quran itself, it's a translation of the meanings of the Quran. It is so powerful even in a translated form. And that's the amazing thing about it. It's so powerful even in a translated form. When you read it in its original language, it's inexplicable to give you the beauty of it in its original format. So it was initially this book, the Quran, that led me to be intrigued about Islam. And you know, that was over 13 years ago. It'll be 14 years this year. And there is not a day that has passed that the Quran hasn't amazed me. And I don't think there will be a day that will pass until the day I die that the Quran would not continue to amaze me, because this is the book from the Creator, it is the miracle from the Creator, and it is a true testament to the fact that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is who he was. I don't need to prove anything else about him other than to give you the Quran and to say this is the testament of who the man was sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it is such a beautiful thing to be able to be part of this great religion, this great way of life, with such a great guidance from the Creator in the Book of Allah and in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So my attraction to Islam was the Quran, and it still is the Quran, inshallah. It will always be, because this is the foundation of everything that we have, is the book, the communication for the Creator. It has been a pleasure to be with you. My name is Yusha Evans again for Quran Weekly, saying Jazakallah khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.